Reading is fun and math is great, but now it's time for art with Miss Kate.
Buenos días, artistas. Emily the art dog is too hot for me to keep holding her. She wanted to get down. Sorry. Today we're going to learn about weaving. We're going to learn how to make a simple weaving first, because I think it's much easier to learn if we start at the beginning instead of way at the advanced end of the spectrum. We're going to learn about an artist named El Anatsui, who was born in Ghana but is based in Nigeria and does these amazing weavings that are 100% recycled. I will attach this link to my lesson. He uses flattened metal bottle caps that he folds over and puts together, and foil from bottles, and all kinds of copper wire, all kinds of cool stuff. And his work inspired me to make this 100% recycled weaving. I wove into a bag with strips from coffee bags and long skinny brown paper bags and receipts that I saved and taped together. When I first started my Art at Home series, I told you I was gonna do a lot of recycling. So I would encourage you to keep saving your things, because we will find ways to use them. Now I'm gonna show you how to do a very simple weaving first, okay? Because I think it's easier to learn that way. Take a paper, fold it in half like a book, okay? Now we're gonna cut from the fold to about right here. You don't have to use a Sharpie. I'm just using it because I've learned that pencil doesn't show up when we film, and I'm gonna cut roughly on these marks. If you wanna take a ruler and measure it, you may, you don't have to. So I'm gonna do this. I'm cutting on the fold. That's important. It won't work if you do it the other way. Weaving is everywhere. It's just that most of it now is done on machines, but the rug I'm standing on is woven. The dress I'm wearing is made out of woven cloth. Most of your clothes are probably woven or knit, but done on machines, okay? I'm just gonna show you the basic concept of weaving, and we're gonna do it by hand. Now I open it up, and I'm gonna weave black strips into this, okay? So this piece right here is called the warp, and what I'm gonna put across is called the weft. I have black strips left over from my demonstration that I made before we started filming. The key to weaving is a pattern. You do here, my weft is under the white. So under, over, under, over, under, over, under, over. For the next step, it has to be opposite. So now I have to start out with the black strip on top of the white. Otherwise, it's not weaving, and it wouldn't end up creating cloth if we were doing this on a loom, okay? So there, here it is over, under, over, under, over, under, over, under. So my next one must start out under the white. Okay, there we go. And you can see that it makes a checkerboard pattern. Here the strip is underneath, here it's on top, here it's underneath. My next one has to start out underneath. I ran out of strips, so I can cut some more. And if you want to measure ahead of time so they're all exactly the same, you can. It's totally up to you, whatever you're comfortable with. Some weavings on purpose have different size strips. For instance, I have one on the table where I used different size strips as an experiment. You can try that too. But first try a simple one so that you understand the concept, okay? So here, and some people like to add a dab of glue underneath the end of the strip to make it more stable. So
If you want to do that, you can. I can take my glue stick. I can do this. This. Whoopsies. There we go. I just made a mistake, but I'm just going to keep going. I make mistakes all the time. It's frankly part of the creative process, and most of my best ideas came from mistakes, and I didn't want to start over, so I had to problem solve. So I kind of welcome mistakes as part of the artistic process. I think they help me be a better problem solver, to be honest. But I do know they upset a lot of people, and they do not upset me. So here we go. Now, I'm going to add some more. You can also tape, if you prefer, to tape those ends to become stable instead of gluing. That's fine too. Here we go. Here's another one. And so you see the pattern. Over, under, over, under, over, under, under, over, under, over, under, over, and it makes a checkerboard. Okay. Now, we're going to pretend this one's finished. When it's finished, it'll look like this. Now I'm going to show you some other types of weaving I did and explain them to you with words as opposed to demonstrations so that my lesson is not too long. This one, I used tissue paper to weave this way, and I used tissue paper to weave this way. This would be an advanced weaving, but you can weave in more than one direction if you want to. If you look at the back, you can see that I started with my yellow construction paper, and then I wove the tissue paper into that. Here I have one where I cut my slots a little bit wider here. Here they're all the same because I wanted to experiment. And I used folded tissue paper to weave with. Okay, this one is not finished, but I wove from both ends, which is another technique you can use. Here, I wove with construction paper and with tissue paper, and I wove with both ends because I wanted to meet in the middle and create a pattern. Here I have some weavings that I did with yarn, and I'm going to show you that on a different day. But here's a circle weaving that I did on a piece of cardboard that a large pizza came on. This one I took off the loom, but I did this on a cardboard loom, and this is yarn. This is my favorite one because a student spent many art classes on it and then gave it to me, and I absolutely love it. They use many different yarns, and they put sticks through the string when they took it off the loom, and I think it's super, super cool. And then I have the one that's 100% recycled to show you. I'm just going to show you how I did this in case you want to try it, but I won't do a long demonstration. For this one, I wove into a bag, a paper bag, and what I did was cut the sides out, saved them, because I can use them to weave with. So I cut these sides out, and then I'm going to fold it in half and cut it the same way I cut the white paper for my demonstration. This is for my recycled stash. I have a huge lawn and leaf garbage bag that I just keep anything I think I might be able to make something out of. And I dip into that for this series as often as I can because we need to stay safe. We can't just go running to the store all the time. And of course, when we do go out, we need to wear a mask. So I'm folding this in half. All right. And then the way I cut this white one was, I'm going to draw this line up here so we don't get confused. You don't have to draw a line if you don't want to. I'm doing it for the purposes of filming. Here I'm going to make my cut marks pretty wide apart because it's faster. You can make yours as close together or wide apart as you want, or vary your widths. That doesn't matter. And then I'm going to cut here on my lines. And when I'm done, I'll have a paper bag weft to weave into with my warp. And my warp is going to be pieces of coffee bag that I can cut into strips. And pieces of brown paper bag and sail slips that I can tape together and weave with. So here we go. I open it up, and now it looks like this paper bag, only before I wove into it. Then you would take strips. I'll just do one strip for my example, for my demo. Like this, say I want to use this coffee bag, which you could use on either side. Here I used it on the orange side. What if I want to use it on the silver side? You could. Then you just do this. Like this. And then your next piece is opposite. You would start underneath the paper bag. And then it would turn out like this. But of course it looks a little bit different. So, there you have it, an introduction to weaving. Look around, start noticing it's all over the place. You're probably wearing some woven cloth. You might be standing on woven cloth. Your couch cover might be woven. And I do hope you check out the link about Anatsui. He's making fantastic artwork. I miss you all. Bye-bye.